So, over the last couple of months, the toy room has been getting a few updates and additions. Right now, I'm up to the Marvel collection. Oops. And depending on how I feel and how I edit this all together, this is either going to be one of my long rambling unboxing videos, or I might just speed up the footage like one of my TikToks. Either way, it's probably a good idea to go get yourself a coffee and a snack and then come right back here. This has actually been a long time coming. Most of these I bought about a year ago, I think. And I don't always unbox them straight away, primarily because, I don't know, maybe secretly I want to do videos like this, but mainly because I need to make space for them first. So let's start with these ones first. Oh. So let's begin by trying to add to the Infinity War Endgame collections. Those two films are the reasons why, well, they're the main reasons why I started collecting Marvel Legends figures. And right now it's all about just sort of replacing kind of crappy versions of characters as well as filling in the gaps. Let's actually start with this one right here. Let's get that. Yeah, I think I won this one for a bargain. I mean, that used to be my main goal with these things. Never pay full price for a Marvel Legends. These Infinity War 2-packs, which were exclusive to certain retailers, were always just a little difficult to find locally here in Australia. Ooh, all that crinkling plastic. Well, there's Bucky right there. There are two weapons in here, two rifles. One looks... Ooh, don't quite recognise that. But I don't even recall seeing that in the film. There's a fairly standard looking rifle with a grenade launcher on there. There we go. That works. And I don't think there's going to be enough room for him to spread his wings. I've actually got Sam in the what's it called, the Civil War version of him, and he's flying above everyone else. And there's not going to be enough room for him to spread his wings like his Civil War version. So, yep, we'll just leave him like that for now. Put that one to the side. Now, let's get to some more gap filling in the collection. And a character that wasn't released as part of Infinity War or Endgame is Drax. My goal is to basically, anyone that had a significant role in either of those two films gets represented on that toy shelf. Yeah, so the funny thing, Guardians didn't get Infinity War versions of themselves. So this is from the Volume 2 collection. If I remember correctly, I got this from one of the toy fairs. Sorry, I have to correct myself. The only Guardians that did get included in the Infinity War, as an Infinity War release, were Rocket and Groot. And they were part of a 3-pack with Thor. So he's got a couple of daggers. He's got a giant cannon on him, but I kind of don't want to pose him with that. There we go, there's Drax. That actually looks really cool. Oh, I just noticed his boots actually have sheaths for the daggers. That's very cool. At time of recording, I do have a Mantis, an incomplete Mantis on the way. She was a builder figure. I was up for auction, but I clicked on the buy now because the price was fine. I did double check to see if I had the missing piece. Sadly not. Unless they release an updated version of Mantis to fit the Infinity Saga, I'm not going to hold my breath on that one, so I thought I'd buy an incomplete one. It's just missing one arm, so I'm not that too concerned. Over there. Speaking of updates and replacements, We're on to Steve Rogers. This is a much better version of Cap than the one that came out during the film's release. Oops. And yeah, so one of the things with the Hasbro's Marvel Legends range is that they'll release a crappy version because most of these toys often get made before a film's release. Oh, okay. Oh, the two shields. Okay, gotcha. So the toy may not resemble what you see on screen. A good example of that is one of Thanos' goons. I can't remember his name now. That one, the one that I've put an insert shot in. They've had to release an Amazon exclusive for that lot, and I can't afford that now. Crunch. Yeah, that is so much nicer. That head sculpt, especially, is so very cool. For a toy of this size, it works really well. Let's put his shields on. Wait. Cool. Oh yeah, that looks awesome. Oh, I'm loving that. Another one from the Infinity War saga re-release gap filling. It's this two-pack of Captain Marvel and Pepper Potts in the rescue armor. Now, this is actually the third release of Pepper Potts in that armor. There was an original Endgame release that had Hulk as the Builder figure part, and then there was a re-release that had Thanos as, I think, armored Thanos as the Builder figure part. Yeah, so this is the third release, but they've added Pepper's actual face sculpt. And also, this would be the first release of Captain Marvel as she appeared in Endgame. So, let's get into that. Again, this is one of those retailer exclusives, but this was much easier to hunt down. Also at a decent price, too. Ooh. Yeah, a couple of different head sculpts. I definitely want to display her with Pepper's face showing, so I need to decide if that's going to be helmet on or helmet off. So I don't mind that as is. You know, that's actually very cool. I'm often impressed with head sculpts at this scale because they're tiny, and I think obviously every Marvel actor by now has been 3D scanned for all the visual effects that they have to do. Actually, I think that might work. That might be preferable for the time being. I like that. I'm a little confused. There's all these extra pieces and I don't know where they're supposed to go. I was actually really happy when they announced this one because, yeah, it's good to have this version of Carol Danvers as well. Crunchy, crunchy, crunchy. Oh, wow. That is such a good head sculpt. I cannot believe that. I am thoroughly impressed with that. That'll be cool. And there. So there we have it. Updates to my Infinity War and Endgame collection thus far. Yeah, now I just need to attach them to these acrylic bases and add them to the collection. Around the same time as Infinity War's release, I discovered a set of re-released Civil War Marvel Legends figures. Civil War being one of my favourite MCU films. The funny thing about that set, though, they didn't include the villain of the piece. And it took the Disney Plus show Falcon and the Winter Soldier for there to be a Baron Zemo figure. I'm going to be adding this version of the character to my Civil War setup. Civil War is one of my favourite films. and I thought it deserved its own shelf on the Marvel displays. He really did become a popular character for a moment there. Oh, that's very cool. Look at that. Yeah, they gave him the comic... Oh, damn. They gave him the comic book-inspired balaclava. I'm losing stuff here. He's got a golden pistol. A Build-A-Figure part, which is basically just Sam Wilson, Captain America's wings. I can't actually remember what it was called, but it's that little book with the trigger words for Bucky to go all Manchurian Candidate. Yeah. Actually, let's get another one of these bases now so we can add him to the display. Speaking of the Disney Plus shows, I've been loving them over the last 2 years. And yeah, of course, they've released figures for those as well, as you saw with the Baron Zemo. I haven't been buying figures for all of them. Just a few select favourites. As much as I've been enjoying all the different shows, I've just been very selective this time. And I thought, yeah, let's get a few of the Loki characters. Obviously, Loki, very popular, so his figure disappeared rather quickly for a while there. Sylvie, lots of Sylvie out there still, but this actually came with a different wave. Mobius, on the other hand, was a retailer exclusive in the US, which meant it never arrived in Aussie stores. I had to order this from a UK-based seller. Fortunately, I had a discount code, so that made things better. So it wasn't... It was actually cheaper than these, I think. But yeah, anyway, let's get into these. Hasn't been released yet, but there is another Loki figure, and I think it comes with a full-size Tesseract. Again, this one is one I bought, yeah, probably last year or whenever it was when it released. Oh, he has no accessories. But there we go. Looking all windswept there. And on the back, says variant. Let's go Mobius next. Like I said, Mobius was a retailer exclusive in the US, but somehow a UK-based seller was actually able to get it in stock. Ooh. Similar thing with Katie from Shang-Chi. Her figure was also a retailer exclusive, and I got it from the same UK seller. I absolutely despise retailer exclusives. There's one right now, which is M'Baku, which was a Build-A-Figure, but then they re-released him as part of the Legacy series. Yeah, unfortunately, retailer exclusive, so not available with the wave that just arrived in Australia as of this recording. Nope, didn't break it. It's... Oh, that is so tiny and fiddly as far as hinges go. That'll have to do. Wow. 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 And then we've got Sylvie, who was actually released as part of a different wave. And her character was really bloody cool, by the way. Do that. We'll take that out and we'll talk about that later. You can kind of see why Hasbro is shifting away from so much disposable plastic. Ooh! Actually, I'm going to keep that on first because... And you'll see in a second, but yep. There we go. That looks really cool, but I didn't realize you could take a cloak off. So... She kind of looks like more like a finale look. And I'm digging that. Yeah, there we go. again, let's put their bases on and add them to the display. Away with thee! Anyway, we still got this here. We're now up to the What If stuff. Yeah, I really enjoy the What If series and looking forward to season 2. I bought the whole set. Yeah, we're going to be able to put together the Build-A-Figure here as well. First of all, Zombie Cap was actually the last one I bought. Most recently, actually. Now that I've found out that there are other zombie characters from that particular episode being released this year, next year, something like that, I thought, let's get this in case I do like those ones enough to be able to create a zombie horde. I'm going to save this one for when that happens. Let's start with the ones I have here, and we'll start with Captain Carter. My god, the internet blew up when she first appeared, eh? I'm so pleased by this character too. That episode was a lot of fun. And yeah, it was also a lot of fun to see Hayley Atwell don the costume in live action as well. Yeah, this is such a cool looking character. There we go. Very nice indeedy. So as of this recording, Chadwick Boseman won a posthumous Emmy Award for his voice work in What If. That was so much fun. That was, hey, you miss him too, don't you? They've got an alternate head for him with the Star-Lord helmet on, the twin blasters, and the Build-A-Figure head. Oh, come on. Oh, he's got tiny Batman the Animated Series ankles. Anyway, here we go. T'Challa, Star-Lord. Oh god, he looks awesome. Right, and from that same episode, Heist Nebula. Oh wow. Jeez, what the... It's like the late night Euros, it just falls apart in your hands. Oh, over there! Gotta be careful. There we go. Heist Nebula, they really did give her some film noir femme fatale type of stylings to her, and it works rather well. Now we've got Doctor Strange Supreme. Like I said, you can understand why they're phasing out the disposable plastic. There's a lot of it. Disposable plastic, as opposed to the plastic crack that we actually pay for. Build a figure part. Right, and I will change this over. That's a really cool outfit. I like that. And let's put his cloak on. That is a nicely molded cloak. But there's our Doctor Strange Supreme. And like I said, that molded cape. That is nice. Very nice indeed. Right, let's move some stuff over. And we have Zombie Hunter Spidey. Oh, again, more plastic. Yeah, cloak. Oh, that's interesting. That's just a really good Spider-Man figure in general, I think. Build-A-Figure part. So, Spider-Man alternate head masked. I'm not sure. I mean, I could have him with the cloak on. That's actually a really cool cloak. I'll decide that a bit later. I might leave it there for now. There is actually one more. Yeah, of course I got the Hydra Stomper. This is how unfit I am. I just lifted that out of the tub and I'm exhausted. That's how heavy this is. This one was a weird one because very few retailers got this in. Oh, there's my receipt. Everything else you could get from a regular department store. I mean, right now, these What If figures, a year later, are are the cheapest they'll ever be, because there are so many of them, and there's a part of me that wishes, oh, I probably shouldn't have bought them so early. I didn't realize I was going to wait a year until opening them, but I just kept pushing this back further and further. But the Hydra Stomper, that's the point I was trying to get at, yeah. It was only available at collectible stores. Wow, that is a hefty son bitch. One thing I'm noticing already, all these bits and pieces like this, they're of a much more flexible plastic. And yeah, they really did realize that how easy it would be for these little tiny things to snap. The entire thing seems to be a much softer... I mean, yeah, there's a lot of softer plastic going on in this one. Sorry, I'm working down here where you can't see, putting together the Hydra Stomper's backpack. This loses marks for not including a tiny Steve Rogers with it. They'll sell him separately as another figure. There was a part of me that was hoping that maybe there was a surprise hatch that opened up. But, yeah, hopefully that locks into place. And... yeah. And there we go. I'm looking at him on the screen right now, and he's not that impressive. I'm looking at him here, and he's like, that's a really cool mech. It's the pose, basically. I need to figure out a good way to do this. However, I'm just thinking now, there's a part of me that thinks they don't scale together. Yeah, there are two footholds here. Oh, that is clumsy. Yep, no, it doesn't work at all. I might have to look it up. If there is an actual way to do it, I might have to look it up, but I don't think it works. But I'm still glad to have it because it is kind of cool. Oh, that's what I forgot. Really should put him out of the way like this. That's his bum. So the Builder figure is the Watcher, and I've got all the parts. I rarely buy whole sets. Builder figures don't often appeal to me, and even then there's always an alternate way to obtain such things. It's like the lower half of him is ready for a swim. Okay, so that, there's a little locking mechanism in there. Then put that in. Now that's a very cool head sculpt. And the Builder figure is the Watcher. That is very nice. Let's swap yours. There you go. Not bad at all, eh? Yeah, these two big fellas probably won't need bases, but everyone else, yeah, let's get those attached and add them to display, and yeah, we can finish up this video.